but I didn't think I'd do it justice. So I said, why not, you know, better talk to someone that is going to be in a situation soon. You'll be getting married soon and you're looking to have a family. Now, it's, oh, you know, it's a male person. So I had a comment, I was doing a video today, and the comment, you know, was basically going back and forth with the discussion, and basically the person was saying they don't think that gay couples should raise children. But I think since you're closer to that, you can shed some light on how you feel about that.
Okay. One, I think anyone who has that, whether they're gay, straight, or otherwise, that have that opinion, maybe you're not a suitable, you know, parent to be. There are folks that I know that are straight that shouldn't have kids, but they had them anyway.
Well, they did make that comment. They said they know heterosexual people who had, but they shouldn't have either.
Second of all, I have two, I would call them brothers/sons, because my mother and I adopted two. They were 2 weeks old when I had them. My sexuality and my sexual preference has nothing to do with how I raised them.
Right.
We raised them with the knowledge of everyone have a choice, whether you're gay, straight, or otherwise. The choice is whether or not you're going to be the best person that you should be, or whether or not you're going to be an asshole. That's your choice. They're Christian assholes, just as if they were sinners' assholes. So at the end of the day, it's not about who's suitable to raise a child. You know, there are people in the world other than America that deals with raising a family. And some of these people have one, some might have 10. But they're better than some parents that are in America working millions or thousands of dollars a year. It's not about the environment. It's about you as an individual. When my mom and I was living in Jamaica, my mom was the best parent that she could be as a single woman.
Let me ask you a question, since you touched on that. As a single woman, do you think having your mom raise you, there's things that you lacked in growing to being a man? Because that was one of the things that was also mentioned, that men can't teach women, can't teach girls how to be women, and women, so if it was two women, women can't teach.
You know, that's bullshit. Because again, I didn't get up any morning of my life putting on a dress because my mother was a woman raising me. Again, stupid people need to stay off the fucking internet. Cut your shit out. At the end of the day, I know that I was bisexual based on that's what I was born as. That's my feelings.
Right, your mom didn't raise you to be
my
a bisexual.
My mom never raised me that. You know, just as if there is, you know, husband and wife raising a boy and he is gay. Has nothing to do with... There's a psychology class that I just took that tells you about sexual identity. Sexual identity is not based on the environment you were raised in, whether or not you're going to lean straight or lean gay. It's you as an individual raising or, you know, being in an environment which is high school. You know, when being gay wasn't popular, there were gay folks in high school. They're being bullied and being picked on and laughed at. But guess what? They were who they are.
Right.
If they could go back and change that, they would still choose to be gay.
Right.
Why? Because it's not a choice. You know, raising a family, you know, whether it's girl, little girls or little boys, as a guardian, that's all you're supposed to do.
Right.
In your wisdom, guard them the best way you can. Provide and nurture whatever the growth is. You're not whispering to them, okay, you're going to be a bottom. No, you're not whispering to that kid in the night, you know, all right, you're going to be a little dyke when you grow up, okay? You're going to have on a hat. No, that's just stupid. For you people, cut it out. If you do not know what it takes to raise even a dog, some people shouldn't even have flowers in their house. You're not a nurturer, so then leave it alone. But again, to each his own. There are good, healthy, straight, and gay individuals around who choose not to have kids. That doesn't mean that they're bad or they're idiots or stupid. That's their choice.
Right.
Just like it's your choice to watch this or not.
As we're going back and forth, another thing that there are 14-year-olds that are married that want to have children. Does that mean that they should? And I was like, wait, you're comparing 14-year-old kids having children, comparing that to gay, to a homosexual couple. And I'm like, that makes no sense. But my thing is, as I thought about it some more, there's some cultures where a 14-year-old having a kid is acceptable.
Yeah.
That's their culture. Mm-hmm. So for my thing is, if bring it back to, here in America, those things are shunned upon because, all right, what's a 14-year-old
think we're better.
A kid? Da, 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 da. But as I said, some cultures, it's fine. Over here in America, 14-year-old, what are you in high school? What are you, 14? You in high school? Junior high. You should be, planning for your future. But that's our culture. Mm-hmm. And who's to say, but my thing is, again, who am I to say that is wrong? That is wrong.
Yeah. I cannot judge anyone in their decision making. I might have an opinion.
Right.
But that's just like everybody have an asshole. Doesn't mean that you need to shit at my house. At the end of the day, it's my choice in what I do.
Right.
When my partner and I finish the paperwork and we get a child, our parent skill is not based on, all right, we're gonna since we went through such issues in our life, we're gonna preach it into him or her that you're gonna be straight. That doesn't work. You're supposed to say, whatever choices you make in life,
I support you.
I love you unconditionally, and let us be clear that in your upbringing, I'm going to give you all the options on the table and allow you to choose. Because again, there's a lot of individuals who have an opinion about, gay men raising kids or lesbians raising kids. There's a whole lot of closeted men that have kids, including pastors, including deacons who are now married and still raising a child, but you still fantasize when you fuck your wife about a dude. Let us be real about our shit. And I think that's something that drives me crazy, because most people tend to have an opinion about me saying that I'm bisexual. I'm bisexual in feelings. I don't always think about it. I don't go through the day going, I'm bisexual. No, these are my feelings. And I'm attracted to a woman, physique and body, just as much as I'm attracted to a dude. But I'm not attracted to every woman, and I'm not attracted to every man. So for those who know themselves, allow them to be the best person that they can be.
Right.
And if they choose to bring a child into that environment, as long as you're not planning to sleep with that child, as long as you're not trying to abuse that child verbally, mentally, or socially in any shape or form.
What's the problem?
Not a problem. My kid is not going to walk in the room and see me on top of my husband. No. There's a lock on my bedroom door, and that's why. And if I was married to a woman, my kid should not walk in my room and see me humping his mother or her mother. At the end of the day, it's based on boundaries. So pretty much what most people are thinking, that gay folks don't have boundaries. So don't trust them with kids. That's pretty much what they're trying to say. But to all of you who say that, eat that. Because at the end of the day, I have no intention to sleep with my kids. That's just nasty. And again, there are straight cultures that they are.
I just saw something else. I was just reading something on Facebook that this girl, a long lost girl, is going to marry her father.
Okay.
And they're straight.
Exactly. Thank
How
you.
Are you doing?
Thank you.